I'm from 82S71. That's like 20, how many, 32 years? 30, wait, sorry, how many years was that?
We reached out to doctors at Tan Tock Seng Hospital to share perspectives on an extraordinary year.
My name is Nelson Chua.
I'm Chin Jingji, 83S71.
My name is Lee Wickly. I'm from 86S78.
I'm Angela Chow from 88S77.
Can you tell us a little about what you do and also how has things changed for you since the COVID virus outbreak?
Oh, Tan Tock Seng Hospital is where I work, and we were supporting the National Center for Infectious Disease, which is where the epicenter of the outbreak, and therefore a lot of our staff were deployed to support NCID work. Currently is quite a testing period for the hospital, because while we are still handling the COVID patients, because the outbreak actually hasn't ended, we're also seeing the regular patients coming back, and then there's a lot of pent-up demand, and we're trying to kind of juggle two kinds of balls at the same time. So it's a busy period in the hospital now.
I'm a preventive medicine physician. My main role is to prevent any transmission in the hospital. Our life was never the same since January 23rd. That was when we had our first confirmed case of COVID-19. Because we were like really busy having to map out where this confirmed case has been and who are the possible individuals who have been in contact with this individual, kind of providing the information to the Ministry of Health so that they can then implement the required measures, quarantine if necessary, to prevent further transmission in the community.
So now I'm a senior consultant anesthesiologist at Tan Tock Seng Hospital, and a big group of us will get rostered to the ICU. We're wearing N95 throughout. Sometimes can be very, very uncomfortable. You know, and I think I've seen even the nurses. In fact, I think they're at the screening center. They wear the gown and they had the braces on the nose of the bridge. They wear that for like hours. And okay, really, it's really kudos to them. You just basically do it.
Yeah, and of course, what's most touching, I think, to a lot of us who was involved in this in NCID and in Tan Tock Seng was when we saw the Bangladeshi patients who actually almost didn't make it and actually had three crashes and was resuscitated, and to be so well, to see his newborn, and he's now back in Bangladesh with his family. I think that is what makes all the work really meaningful and worthwhile.
At least someone at my age would have gone through SARS and H1N1. I think the real difference between this outbreak and the previous outbreak is that I think there's a lot of empathy from the public and a lot of concern, and that was overtly demonstrated.
I think the difference there at the time was that, you know, I don't know if you remember SARS initially, the nursing staff were and the nurses were all really avoided. People really avoided Tan Tock Seng, you know, the buses refused to stop at Tan Tock Seng level, and then we were like, you know, like hurry up, like that. Everybody's avoided us. And then this time around, I think a lot of people were very appreciative very early. So we had, you know, people baking cookies for us, everything. And we constantly get food. So I think we're well taken care of by the people of Singapore.
What keeps me going now is actually teaching the next generation. I think that gives me the satisfaction of doing it. And I'm starting to see a lot of young, you know, radiologists or those, you know, practitioners in neuroscience, they are starting to get interested in you know, neuro intervention work.
I think in healthcare, a lot of us, even in the different subspecialties, in the different family groups, I think the key thing is that joy in having being able to help someone, I guess. I think that's what healthcare is all about, actually. It's about making a difference to somebody else's life. And I think healthcare people tend to like to be helpful. If you feel that, you know, making someone feel better, happier, makes you happy even more, then I think healthcare is for you. It's not easy work. It is hard work, but I guess at the end of it, the joy that you derive from it kind of overcomes everything else.
And now we come to the last question, which is 2020 has been a challenging year for many people, and it's also Hwa Chong JC's 46th anniversary. Do you have any special messages for friends or alumni?
Every year when it comes to anniversary, I think that is the only time I receive a lot of messages in our class chat group. I think, you know, it's a time to get together. And I take this opportunity to wish, like, you know, every year, right, a happy anniversary. And it's a nice time to catch up. I think this, you know, celebration should just go on. So for the younger ones, you must keep this tradition, you know, alive and actively participate.
The most common advice is wear your mask and have social distancing. Take care of yourself, right? I guess there's always a little bit of fatigue with all this lockdown a bit, and after a while, so you know, everyone just take care, be safe, and I think so we're doing all right from the healthcare front of it. I think we're still managing well. There was once I think there's a big celebration, so I know my class actually had a table. I'd love to go back to one of those alumni dinners when everything's back to normal and we can gather again.
So I think, you know, for those of us, especially at my age, it is perhaps after the outbreak, it is time to reconnect and you know, catch up with one another. And I think these are things that are probably far more meaningful. So I think we should all learn to appreciate what we already have. That will really make us much more happier and look forward to the next day.